In the very first video on this channel, I started building an acrobatic robot. This robot is designed to swing from a pendulum and perform one or two backflips, just like Disney's Stickman robot. I would also like to be able to launch it from an elastic cord like later versions of Disney's acrobatic robots, their Stuntronics. In the last video, when I ended, the robot was pretty complete, but right now, it's basically stripped down to nothing. So in this video, we're going to look at what electronics I'm going to install on the board and why I stripped it to bits. But before we look at the electronics, let's look at the physics behind this robot's operation when it's flipping through the air. We all know the concept of momentum, the property of an object determined by the equation P equals mv. This means that momentum goes up as mass increases or as velocity increases. It also means that momentum goes down as mass decreases or as velocity decreases. We also know Newton's first law. It says that an object at rest will stay at rest, and an object at motion will stay in motion as long as no external forces are applied. That's just a fancy way of saying that momentum wants to stay constant. So if you're on a frictionless table and momentum is constant, the way you change your velocity is by changing the mass. The same concept works on rotating objects as well, except the equation changed from momentum equals mass times velocity to angular momentum equals moment of inertia times angular velocity. Moment of inertia is the measurement of how far mass away is from the axis of rotation and how heavy it is. So the heavier an object is and the farther away it is from the axis of rotation, then the more moment of inertia you'll have. And because angular momentum is always going to remain constant, changing the moment of inertia will change the angular velocity. This is actually how this robot's going to work, by using the concept of angular momentum. To change its angular velocity so that it lands flat on its back, it's going to change its moment of inertia by opening and closing its legs like this. When it's open, the mass is far away from the center of rotation, which will be right about here. So the moment of inertia will be higher, so the angular velocity will be lower. But when it closes like this, the moment of inertia decreases because the mass moves closer to the center of rotation. Because of this, the angular velocity will increase so that momentum stays constant. But then the question becomes, when should the legs open and close? In order to figure this out, we need two things. Sensors to determine where we are in the world, and a policy to take that information and turn it into how the servo should move. So let's look at the sensors and how they're going to be used by the policy. So the first thing that the policy is going to need is it's going to need to know how long until it's going to hit the floor. And in order for this, we're going to use this module. This is an HCSR04. It's an ultrasonic module, so it reads how long it takes sound waves to come back after being bounced. So from that, you can determine distance. It's going to go right here. We're going to use that to determine the distance, then we're going to take the derivative of that distance to find its vertical velocity. By using the vertical velocity and the height in the air and the known acceleration due to gravity, which is 9.81, we can determine how long until it's going to hit the ground. Next up, we're going to need two more things, angular velocity and what angle we're currently at. And to do this, we're going to use this. This is an MPU9250, is an IMU, so it uses an accelerometer and a gyroscope to determine which direction gravity is pulling, and from that, it can figure out at what angle it is facing. That's going to be mounted there. In the last video, I mounted an Arduino Uno right here, but in this video, I'm going to add a Raspberry Pi Pico instead. The reason I'm doing this is because the Arduino Uno was not nearly strong enough to run the algorithm that I'm going to have to use on this. But before we talk more about the algorithm, let's solder this all together. Just like that, all the soldering is done. But you may notice that something still isn't quite done, and that's this release mechanism right here. This mechanism is designed to let go of the trapeze at the right moment. But right now you can see it's just a bare servo. I had to get rid of our old design because it just wasn't good, so let's look at what went bad and how we're going to fix it. So this was the original design for the release mechanism. You can see it has this little hook here connected to the servo and a little lid here. The rope goes through this spot, and then when the servo opens like this, when it opens up, the rope is designed to fall out. Now that sounds great in theory, but because this piece of plastic was so thin, it just bent out of the way, so that whole piece of plastic lifted up and the rope just slid out. So what I'm gonna do is make this much thicker, and I'm also gonna design it so that this comes up through a slot here, like this. So that this comes up through a slot, there'll be a slot here, so that there's no plastic to bend to get out of the way, so the rope always has to stay in until the servo opens. So here's what this new design looks like. You can see it has a much thicker upper lid, and this bar here, this release mechanism, goes up into here. So through this hole, we'll slip a piece of rope, and there's no way it's getting out of that. And if we do a much stronger shake test, you'll see it has no way of getting out. So the rope will only fall out when I want it to. Also, if we look over the robot as a whole, we can see since the last video I've upgraded this battery to be an actual LiPo battery instead of phone chargers. I have these two voltage regulators here. One regulates for 6 volts for the servos, so they move faster with the most torque they have, and one for 5 volts for all the electronics over here. And also, I've included this button on the back. And this button will have a very important function, in that when I release the robot, I'm going to be holding this button, and as soon as I let go, that will start the AI to tell the servos how to move. Speaking of the algorithm that's going to run this robot, let's talk about it. So I'm going to do something really cool for this robot, which is create a physics simulation that, as perfectly as I can, models this robot and how it's going to swing through the air. Then, I'm going to run reinforcement learning on it, whether that's a genetic algorithm or Q-learning. And from that, I'm going to put it on the real robot, the policy learned by the computer on the simulation, put it on the real robot, and if everything works out, it should just work really nicely. So, in the future videos of this series, we're going to look at how that works, but for now, I'm going to end this video here. I hope you really liked it and learned a little bit too. If you liked this video, be sure to subscribe and hit the like button. Feel free to leave any comments down below if you have any questions or you just want to say it looks cool. See you next time. Ah.